Hi, this is Mike Tholfsen from the Microsoft Education Team. I'm going to be presenting at this ISTE content session on what's new in OneNote EDU. Now, I work on the Microsoft Education Team. I work a lot with OneNote. I've got my very special cape on to match my purple outfit. And as a bonus, because it's a pandemic, this is from Iceman Tuck's mother. She made me this wonderful OneNote mask. Wow. Check that out. I'm fully ready for my presentation. But don't worry, I'll take this off while I'm talking. So I'm going to be talking about all the latest cool stuff that's been happening with OneNote in education. Now, before I get into the details, just at a high level, in this unprecedented time, schools, universities, everyone needs remote learning to meet their needs. And it could be remote learning or hybrid learning or something in between. Everything from the online infrastructure to communication tools like Microsoft Teams, inclusive access. So how can we make sure accessibility, inclusion are all part of that equation? And then user readiness, which is more like training and professional development. And so this is something that Microsoft Education is thinking about holistically across the board. So we'll dive in and talk about what's new in OneNote EDU. The first thing, and maybe most important, is that OneNote Desktop, OneNote 2016, is not going away. We're going to be launching an updated and refreshed version in winter of 2020, probably in January timeframe-ish, and it's going to start rolling out. It'll have new updates like Modern Sync. We'll be bringing the Math Assistant and all those tools from OneNote Windows 10 into OneNote Desktop. It'll get built-in dictation. The Immersive Reader will be built in. Class Notebook tools. And later on, OneNote Live Captions will come. This will also be part of the Office 2019 default installation for Office Pro, and we'll be updating and improving desktop. So we heard people loud and clear, and OneNote is not going away for the desktop version. It's coming back. Another recent update, we added Adobe Spark video support. You can now paste an Adobe Spark video right into OneNote, like you see here, and play it just like a video. Kind of like we support YouTube embedded videos, you can now put in Adobe Spark videos. You can also paste in Adobe Spark pages, like you see here. That is just rolled out recently, and we encourage you to try that one out. The other one that's recently rolled out is the Immersive Reader for a form that is embedded in OneNote. What does that mean? Well, if you have a Microsoft form, and you paste a link to it in OneNote, it will render that form. Here's an example of a math problem in a Microsoft form. You can now enable the Immersive Reader on that form that is embedded inside of OneNote. This is an example of a practice math quiz. That feature has been around for quite a long time. That is now available as well. When you paste that quiz form in OneNote and it generates, you can turn on the Immersive Reader. This makes math more inclusive. You can read your math out loud. You can translate things into different languages with story problems. Any type of form that you have, you can now turn on the Immersive Reader, which is great for students, as we talked about inclusive and equitable access. Now, this next feature I'm incredibly excited about. This is another inclusive and accessible feature, and it's now in private beta in OneNote for the web, and it's in private beta for OneNote Windows 10 app. It's called OneNote Live Captions. Well, what does that mean? We have Microsoft Translator fused together with OneNote. So why would you want to do that? Well, imagine, and especially during remote learning or hybrid learning, you have students that are deaf and hard of hearing, students that don't speak the native language, students that are dyslexic or dysgraphic and get overwhelmed by information. Microsoft Translator allows the educator to generate a join code. This already exists. Translator is free on iPhones or Android or the web. As an educator, I can start a translator session and generate a 5-digit code. Now imagine I gave that code to all my students either over Teams or an email. Any student or parent for that matter can take that 5-digit code. And I'm going to play this video. So imagine teacher Mike just generated a 5-digit code for all my little students in the ISTE audience. You all got that code. So I'll hit play. So the student goes to the View tab, they click Live Captions, the new feature, and enters the join code and chooses the language. So as Professor or Teacher Mike is talking, you can see it's captioning over here on the right-hand side. I can take notes as a student, and I can pause the captions. So I pause the captions as a student. I'm highlighting all these things. I can make the text bigger. When I hit resume, all those captions keep going. And because it's in OneNote, everything's saved in the transcripts folder on the left. So there's a section for transcripts, and look at this. Everything I was saying is automatically captured in transcripts. We support other languages. If I speak Japanese as a student, I can drop that captions language and choose Japanese. And now, as the teacher is talking, all those captions and transcripts come through in Japanese, and they're automatically saved. This is unique, it's pretty incredible, and it's incredibly inclusive. So this is called OneNote Live Captions. It's in beta right now. We hope to ship it more broadly in spring of 2021, ultimately bringing it to all OneNote platforms. Also, we have the Math Assistant in OneNote for iPad. If you've used math in OneNote, you know that it has the problem-solving capabilities, it has quiz, it has Ink to Math, it has the Math Solver, and it has the Immersive Reader for all math. There's a little button. We're bringing all of these math capabilities that the web and OneNote for Windows 10 already have, we're bringing those into iPad this spring. So stay tuned. Later this spring, you're going to get a full, all the OneNote math features coming into iPads for those of those schools that are using a lot of iPads, maybe with younger students as well. Now we're going to move on to class notebook updates. I'm a big fan of the OneNote class notebook. It's even better when it's inside of Microsoft Teams. Microsoft Teams is our education hero offering. You know, have all your class assignments and a class notebook in Teams. So we've added some great updates in our class notebook inside of Teams recently. First off, when you're creating a new assignment, you can create a new file. It used to be you could only create a new Word, Excel, or PowerPoint file when you were making this new file button. Now you can create a new OneNote class notebook page at the same time. You can create the page, you can attach it to assignment, you can even fill out that page, and then distribute it to all your students as an assignment. So that is fully rolled out. We also have the ability to put assignments, distributing them into a section group. In this case, I have an assignment that I've made in my class notebook. Now, in the OneNote standalone, you can have nested section groups. So that might mean I've got Unit 1 section group, Unit 2 section group, and we've got nested sections. You can see in this image here, you've got Week 1, and then there's some sections in here, and then there's Week 2. It used to be inside of Teams, you could not distribute a page into a nested section group. That's what we call these here. Well, now you can, just like in the standalone class notebook. So we're really trying to bring all the parity features into Teams assignments. This is now rolled out and available, so you can distribute a page into a nested section group. Here's a video of kind of what that looks like. I'm gonna go through and click create, fill out my assignment, and add resources. I'll choose class notebook. I'm gonna make my assignment, drill into the content library. Here's my unit 1 and 2 readings. There's a regular page, but I might say, hey, there's unit 2, unit 3, right there. You can expand those. So that shows you how to make that assignment in the nested section group. Next up, set the default channel in a Teams class or staff notebook. Well, what does that mean? We call this the Dr. David Kellerman feature, who's our favorite professor from Australia. He really wanted this feature. So when you have a class notebook, you have the collaboration space and the content library. And when it's inside of Teams, you can create channels in Teams. Some people like to create channels for project groups. And when you create a channel, it creates a notes section that's collaborative in that channel, so everyone can access it in the collaboration space. Dr. Kellerman wanted that to go into the content library. He said, I teach by units, and each channel is a unit that I want read-only notes for all my students. I don't want it to be collaborative. So I'm gonna show a little video that shows how you can take that collaboration space or content library channel and switch the defaults. We've also made it easier to know when you create channel notes like here, where that lives. What we heard was, hey, when you create those new note sections, it's not clear that it's in the collaboration space. And you can see now it will tell you where it goes. I'm gonna show the video here how this all works. So I'm gonna go to class notebook in Teams and click the manage notebooks. And there's this setting, set default location, collaboration space or content library. So here it's for the collaboration space. I create a new channel, Project Team Red, and there's a couple channels here. When I go to notes, it says start collaborating. This content lives in the collaboration space. So this is how it shows all inside the collaboration space for each channel. Now you can see those three sections are created in the collaboration space. Now we'll go and set it the default to be the content library. So now it's going to create new sections read only in the content library instead. So now I'll create a few new channels, unit 1, unit 2, and unit 3. And now when I go into notes, it says it goes to the content library. And when I open and expand this, you're going to see that all these new sections 1, 2, and 3 live in the content library instead. So it allows you to switch back and forth, which is perfect for Dr. Kelleman and probably perfect for a lot of other educators. So those are the top updates for OneNote in Education, but I do have some great resources for everyone. First off, I started a Quick Tips YouTube channel designed for educators. Here's the link here. I encourage you to go and subscribe to this channel because multiple times a week I am putting really short and sweet 2, 3, 4 minute videos on how to use different features. OneNote, Teams, Immersive Reader, inclusive and accessible technology, PowerPoint, OneNote. And I even have a quick tips playlist specifically on OneNote. So if you want to dive into math tools or what you can embed into OneNote or how to use a staff notebook or live captions or whatever it might be, those are some great tips right there for you. There are also some resources here. There's a OneNote education page on the MEC. I've got a nice OneNote Wakelet. And I also put some nice Teams EDU MEC pages in here as well. And there's a Teams Wakelet. Now, if you want to get today's presentation, I have the link right here. There's also a QR code. And I also encourage you, send me an email or follow me on Twitter. Tweet me out. I'm very active on Twitter. And I hope you give us feedback because we're always listening. And have a great rest of your ISTE. Bye-bye.